The construction for the Ministry of Education and Sports headquarters will help the ministry save up to 4.5 billion shillings on rent annually. Currently, the ministry rents office space for its technical staff and departments in various private buildings. During her speech, the Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Kataha Museveni, noted that having their own headquarters has been one of the priorities for the ministry over the years.
Yes, the groundbreaking of our ministry headquarters. We come with joy to celebrate the faithfulness of our God. After many years of prayer and planning, our dream of having our own home is finally in our view. And knowing our God, He never starts anything He will not finish. For a long time, the key departments and units of our ministry have been accommodated at various locations around Kampala. And these include Embassy House, Legacy Towers, on Nakasero Hill and Chambogo, among others. This has not only been costly in terms of expenditure on rent, but it has also compromised efficiency with our own home here at Chambogo now. We hope to be able to have a common place of convergence as a family, and this will ease coordination among departments as well as improve our efficiency.
The education minister added that challenges of coordination in the ministry's work is decentralized offices had been a hindrance to successful service delivery, but with construction of the permanent offices, this will be solved.
I must also be quick to add that a home is more than just a building. A home is made up of loving relationships. Therefore, as we embark on the construction of our home, I urge each one of us to endeavor to create the unity that we need to accomplish the work that God has given us in this season. Work is accomplished through a united team because we each have different strengths and abilities. So when we create groups and isolate others, we deny ourselves their significant contribution and our work suffers.
The Minister of Education's Permanent Secretary, Katie Lamaro, noted that the construction project is estimated to cost 61.9 billion shillings, with 68% of the financing coming from a loan obtained from the Islamic Development Bank, while the government will contribute the remaining 32%.
Thank you. I would like to make it clear at this ceremony that we are all accountable to the Ugandan taxpayer, and our collective efforts should be geared towards ensuring value for money on this project. I'm aware that the Islamic Development Bank will pay up to 68% of the contract sum, while government will foot the remaining 32%. I therefore pledge our best efforts to ensure timely allocations and payments for the government portions of the contract payments with support from the Ministry of Finance, Planning and Economic Development. Mama, under your leadership, the Islamic Development Bank has been one of the key partners we have in education. We greatly appreciate and value your friendship and cooperation.
The ministry headquarters complex will consist of two towers, one with 8 floors and the other with 10 floors. Additionally, the complex will include a 600-seat auditorium and 2 parking decks. Upon completion, the headquarters will be capable of accommodating more than 700 staff, and it's expected to be ready within 18 months from the commissioning date. Report compiled by Sharon Navasidie for the news.